Greetings. Another reason to reject Islam. Reason 5. Islam spreads willful ignorance. I have another video titled Tafsir, Deedat Wisdom 04 is Hallelujah, Alleluhey. And here's the link. In the video, I clearly teach the actual origins of the word Hallelujah and dissect and refute Ahmed Deedat's badly flawed claim it is Alleluhey. Some time ago, a Mohammedan posted a comment on that video with some profanity. F you, you can just judge the religion due to a mistake a single Muslim made ignoring the mistakes in the Bible. Who's the stupid one here? Now, I can understand from the perspective of this Mohammedan, he thinks I am stupid to reject Muhammad's religion. But I find his attack contains an interesting admission. Due to a mistake a single Muslim made. Bless this man's heart, he admits Deedat made a mistake. Deedat was wrong. In a way, I do not mind the profanity, because I know the heart of Islam is literally full of hate and anger. This is because the Allah of Islam is full of hate and anger. And a spirit, Satan, could not create a religion that has a different spirit than he himself has in his essence. Moving on. Anyway, I posted the following series of 500 character replies until the messages began to flow and I thought it deserved a video to document it a little better. I understand your anger, my friend. Pride makes one angry when they are too proud to be embarrassed. Deedat was a proud and foolish man who had glory from the crowds he wowed. But wowing unlearned people is no accomplishment. Mohammed's religion is a deception and a lie, brother. Do you want to go to hell? Do you want to reject truth and knowledge and God's patient love for you? While you curse me, my friend, I will pray for you. This is the love God has shown us all. I praise the living God, Yahweh. I say Hallelujah, meaning praise to Yah. If you want to show respect to God, my friend, you would learn the message of the true Injil that Jesus brought and passed on to his disciples. What man has said that the Injil is corrupt? Can you produce your proof, Surah and Ayat, where the Quran says the Injil is corrupted? When you cannot produce your proof, open your eyes to the consequence, my friend. The Bible is the true word of Almighty God. You think that I judge Mohammedism by a mistake of a single Muslim. First, brother, let that sink in. Deedat made a mistake. He was wrong. His story was wrong. His claim was wrong. His teaching was false, false, false on this issue. And was Deedat an ignorant goat herder who could not read? Or was he the most well-known speaker for the whole religion of Mohammedism in his lifetime? Was there not one single person in your religion who could catch and correct his error? Not see it? And that was when the realization hit me. Not one single person in Islam could see the truth. Not one single person in Islam desired the truth enough to learn the Greek. Or if they did learn the Greek and learned the truth, they left Islam for the truth. But I ask you, O Mohammedan, the same question as the YouTube poster. Do you want to go to hell? Do you want to reject truth and knowledge and God's patient love for you? Was Deedat an ignorant goat herder who could not read? Or was he the most well-known speaker for the whole religion of Mohammedism in his lifetime? Was there not one single person in your religion who could correct his error? Could not even see it? If not, what does that tell you about the very sad condition of Islam? It creates such ignorance that simple language errors cannot be caught. Wake up, O Mohammedan, when you could know the truth, with only small effort, or with no effort, because I told you the truth in my video of the word, then you are choosing to be willfully ignorant. What is it about Islam that makes Mohammedans willfully ignorant? Willfully ignorant of so many things. I know this video started with one angry person from Islam dismissing a gross mistake by the most visible spokesperson for Mohammed's religion this past century. But it changed in direction to be questioning how and why. I think the core problem is Islam creates willful ignorance. And that is why I reject Islam. So you should reject Islam. Do you want to remain willful and rebellious against Al-Haq, the truth? Or do you truly want to submit to God? To abandon and avoid willful ignorance, you must reject Muhammad's Islam. If Deedat can teach this error, and not one man in Islam can catch it, shame, shame, shame. Shame on Islam for making people willfully ignorant. And shame on you, O Mohammedan, for wasting the brain that Almighty God gave you. And just to be perfectly clear, I call you Mohammedan because someone who is willfully ignorant and rejects the truth is rejecting Al-Haq himself, and cannot be submitted to God. You cannot be Muslim and reject the truth. And wake up, O Christians! Not one single person in Islam could see the truth. That should break your heart and shake you to your core. Christians, let that sink in. The blindness of Islam is all-consuming. Not one single person in Islam could see the truth. How will they know if you do not tell them? How can you tell them if you are afraid of them? Or worse, if you hate them? Christians, do not hate those who curse you and despitefully use you. Matthew 5:44, But I say unto you, love your enemies, bless them that curse you, and do good to them that hate you, and pray for them which despitefully use you and persecute you. This is the pure gospel. That is the whole difference between God's message and Muhammad's twisted message from Satan. God's true gospel is a chronicle of redemption and patient long-suffering and God's forgiveness to us. They will know we are Christians by our love. Not our clever arguments, not our knowledge of Greek, not our skill at debate. They will know we are Christians by our love. 1 John 4:7, Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God. And everyone that loveth is born of God and knoweth God. He that loveth not knoweth not God, for God is love. In this was manifested the love of God toward us, because that God sent his only begotten Son into the world, that we might live through him. This is the pure gospel. And O Mohammedan, you can never be Muslim, submitted to God, until you submit to God's Son, the Lord Jesus. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.